the sanctified life, love for God and men. Those who have genuine love for God will manifest an earnest desire to know His will and to do it. Says the Apostle John, whose epistles treat so fully upon love, "This is the love of God, that we keep His commandments." 1 John 5 verse 3. The child who loves his parents will show that love by willing obedience, but the selfish, ungrateful child seeks to do as little as possible for his parents, while he at the same time desires to enjoy all the privileges granted to the obedient and faithful. The same difference is seen among those who profess to be children of God. Many who know that they are the objects of His love and care, and who desire to receive His blessing, take no delight in doing His will. They regard God's claim upon them as an unpleasant restraint, His commandment as a grievous yoke. But he who is truly seeking for holiness of heart and life delights in the law of God and mourns only that he falls so far short of meeting its requirements. We are commanded to love one another as Christ has loved us. He has manifested His love by laying down His life to redeem us. The beloved disciple says that we should be willing to lay down our lives for the brethren. For everyone that loveth him that begat, loveth him also that is begotten of him. Verse 1. If we love Christ, we shall love those who resemble Him in life and character. And not only so, but we shall love those who have no hope and are without God in the world. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 12. It was to save sinners that Christ left His home in heaven and came to earth to suffer and to die. For this He toiled and agonized and prayed until, heartbroken and deserted by those He came to save, He poured out His life on Calvary. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 10, Christian Character.